Having a bad hair day? Thinking of booking a spot at the hair salon to mix up your look? Well, before you get bangs or a mohawk, put down the scissors and think. What about wigs? Ever considered them? You're not the first. The wig trend actually began over 200 years ago, long before extensions and weaves went on the market. Let's travel back in time, shall we? Cleopatra, Julius Caesar, Charles II? Yep, they all wore wigs. Queen Elizabeth I even had a collection of 150 wigs made to conceal her graying locks. King Louis XIV started wearing wigs at age 17 when his hair started thinning and members of his court started making jokes about his receding hairline. By age 30, he'd commissioned over 40 wig makers to design and create his hair pieces at the court of Versailles. Soon, his courtiers began wearing wigs, and as France was considered to be the hub for haute couture, the wig craze soon spread across Europe. But for most, wigs weren't worn as an optional accessory. Diseases like syphilis and the plague ran rampant, bringing along side effects like balding and lice. Wigs were the obvious solution to hide the telltale signs of illness and preserve the dignity of the aristocrats. And when people found that wigs were far easier to clean and maintain, their popularity grew. Wigs were more popular with men until Marie Antoinette came along. She was not only regarded as the Queen of France, but also the Queen of Fashion. Her most iconic styles included 30-pound poofs, 5-foot feather creations, and famously intricate designs, like a replica of a French naval ship. Each day, she sported a different style. By powdering her poofs in shades of lilac, baby pink, and light blue, and adding flowery fragrances, jewels, and other ornaments, Marie Antoinette was never found wanting for a new hairdo. Ladies of the court of Versailles soon followed suit, always attempting to emulate Antoinette's fashion-forward ways. Wigs soon became a mark of status and wealth, and were mostly worn by upper-class nobles who would afford the high price tags. So it's no surprise that at the start of the French Revolution, wigs were symbolic of the excesses of the aristocracy. With war raging, the toupee trend quickly came to an end, and natural hair has been in style ever since. What do you think? Would you try a wig to spice up your hairstyle?